important equipment called a battery life cycle tester. It can be used to test, charge and discharge the battery in a way what we desire in terms of power level and the current density operation. This equipment has 400 amperes and 60 volts, so that we can test battery stacks of up to 24 kilowatts. And it has four channels. All the leads of the battery cycler can be connected to the VRFB battery. This battery stack we have built in-house as part of this project, which is aiming towards having a 5 kilowatt flow battery stack. And my prior staff Bharat will explain the piping, the fluid distribution network in this flow battery stack.
Flow battery stack, we have to send the electrolyte, which is stored in this reservoir. We have both reservoirs, positive and negative. We are sending the liquid by using peristaltic pump. It's pumping the liquid to the inlet manifold. That manifold is strip the liquid up to each cell. And we are getting the outlet to outlet manifold. And we are connecting back to the same tank, like each positive and negative.
We are measuring the battery current, voltage, ampere hour, and wattage, the energy. In addition to the built-in measuring parameters for the battery cycler, we are measuring the weight and liquid levels of both the positive and negative tanks. And this will help us to study how the crossover of electrolyte from positive to negative or negative to positive is happening inside the VRFB stack through the membrane, which is not harmful for the health of electrolyte in long term, because VRFB has similar ion on both the sides, so we can regenerate through chemical or electrochemical route. So, and we need a sophisticated crossover phenomena to have the life of the electrolyte in a stationary grid scale and distribution system. We are measuring the through software the parameters of the battery. Let's say at some current density of 90 milliamps per centimeter square. So we have done 5 life cycles. As I said earlier, we are measuring the voltage, watts, powers, ampere hour, which is the capacity, and watt hour, which is the energy of the stack given and taken out from the stack. Let's say if you want to see the power level at any cycle, so we have this. This is the charging power of the stack is around 3.5 kilowatts. And we have given 25 ampere hours, and we have added 600 watt hours to it at the voltage of 26 volts. And when we go towards the discharge, we have different other parameters. So the discharge power will be around 2.3 kilowatts at a low voltage of around 18 volts, and we will be taking several ampere hours or watt hours from the battery. So with this, we can calculate the efficiency parameters of the VRFB stack by having these parameters measured through the battery cyclers.
The electrochemical studies that we can do from battery cycler, we are also monitoring the health of the electrolyte, both positive and negative electrolyte, for this particular battery. Finding out the concentration of the various ions that are present, which are basically different ionic states of iridium, that is B2, B3, B4, B5, using ion chromatography. We have done the study for various cycles, for charge, discharge cycles of various batteries and various single cell studies that we have done. We'll go see concentrations have been determined and so forth.
I am conducting the electrochemical performance of VRFB at low temperatures, up to minus 10 degrees Celsius. So I am using the environmental check up to minus 40 degrees Celsius, and presently I am having a cell. Kept inside this chamber. So this is presently I am doing the pressure drop measurements.
Have you got that?
this is the environment chamber. Here I am maintaining the required temperature, and this is I am carrying out the study in a single cell VRFB. So from the electrolyte tank, the electrolyte is circulated through the peristaltic pump, and temperature is measured through thermocouple. Electrochemical performance, the leads from the battery cycler is connected to the cell to measure the electrochemical performance. Monitoring the performance of my single cell through this biologic potentiostat. So I am conducting the experiments at low temperature. We can see the performance deteriorates at low temperature. The discharge capacity at 25 degrees Celsius is shown in the blue color line, and we can and the discharge charge and discharge cycles are shown in red color at 10 degrees Celsius. And if we observe the green line, which is the green curve, which is showing the performance of single cell VRFB at minus 10, we can see around half amount of the discharge capacity is reduced at minus 10 degrees Celsius. Presently, I am working on to improve the performance of low temperature VRFB by changing the electrode parameters and other design parameters. Apart from in-situ measurements of electrochemical performance of the VRFB, at low temperatures, I am also using this cryostat, which can go up to minus 25 degrees Celsius. So here I am using this for finding out the physical properties of the electrolyte, like density, viscosity. So I will immerse the electrolyte inside the bath, and corresponding measurements I will. We can change the temperature like this.